viewers, welcome back to another tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to talk about the advanced solar panel cleaning system part 2. And first of all, I would like to thank you for the huge number of responses that you gave me on the previous solar panel video, and that's why I decided to upload the second part of the video. And this second part is going to have much more advanced features that was not present in the previous video. So this one is going to be the much more advanced project. As before, we have got the current and voltage measurements along with the temperature and humidity measurements. We have got the automatic battery charging feature, which was not present in the previous video. So what this feature is basically doing is it automatically charges the battery when the battery voltage falls below the threshold. And we have got the full load control capability as well, so we will talk about that later. And we have also got the dry and wet cleaning feature as before, but this feature here is going to be much more advanced and the mechanism is much more efficient than before. And we have also got the timing control feature, which was also not present in the previous video. So let's just start the components. This is the list of the components that we have used in this project. We'll talk about it now. So first of all, we have got the ACS7124, the 5 ampere variant. We have used the 5 ampere variant to take the current reading of the load. And on this side, you can connect the microcontroller, and on this side, you connect the load. We have also used the voltage sensor here, and this one is called the voltage divider voltage sensor. And you must note that the voltage reading falls in this range, so you have to make sure that whatever load you have, that load must have the voltage which must fall in this range. And we have also got the DHT-11 RDC module. So this one is new here. This one, what this is basically doing is giving you the timing control feature that I talked about previously. So what is basically the timing control feature is, let's say you want to find out at what particular time your load was either on or off, or if you want to say at what particular time the current of the load was and at what particular time the voltage was. So if you want to find out those parameters, so we can use this RDC module, and we will take those voltage readings, those current readings, and the state of the load, and we will take the time from this module and we will show it on to the LCD. So this is one of the main advantage of this using this RDC module. The second advantage will be the alarm feature. So basically, you can set the alarm time, so when the alarm goes off, the load will be either on or off. And we have used the DHT-11 sensor. This sensor is going to be used for the temperature and humidity measurements. So on the package inside, we have got the chip here, which is going to be the thermistor, which is going to measure the temperature. And we have got the ultrasonic sensor as before, but we are going to use three of them. And as I told you before, that the dry and wet cleaning system is much more advanced and much more efficient. So how does this dry cleaner, the cleaner system works is like it cleans the solar panel segments by segment. So that means the cleaner will clean the segment one using forward and backward movements. Once it moves horizontally and will clean the second segment using forward and backward movement, will clean the third segment using same technique, and the process is repeated. So this is why we have to know at what particular distance we need to stop the cleaner, at what particular forward distance we need to stop the cleaner, and we also have to know at what particular backward movement we have to stop the cleaner, we have to stop the brush. So that's why two of the sensors are used for the forward and backward distances. And since the cleaner is also moving horizontally onto the surface of the solar panel, so that's why we need to know at what particular horizontal distance we need to stop the cleaner and move it to the to its original position. So two of the ultrasonic sensors was used for the forward and backward distances, and the third one is used for the horizontal distance. So that's why we have used three of them. And as before, we have used the relay module, but it's two channel here. Why two channel? As I told you, that the forward and backward movement and the horizontal movement is also there. So we have used three motors for that purpose. You can say that the forward movement, the two motors are controlled by the motor driver, and the third motor does not need to control the speed. So since we are not controlling the speed of the horizontal motor, so that's why we are controlling that motor, that horizontal motor, via this relay module here. So this one relay here will be controlling the horizontal motor, and this second relay as before is going to control the water pump as before. And we have got the motor driver, and as you can see, this motor driver is different from the previous one. We have not used the L298 motor driver because our motors are taking huge amount of current, which L298 cannot handle. So that's why we have used this high current motor driver, which has the maximum current capability of the 43 amps. So one of the disadvantages of using this motor driver is you can control only single motor via this motor driver over here. So since we have got three motors, two motors are using motor drivers, so the forward and backward motor will be using this motor driver, and that's why we used two of them. And one of the most interesting feature is using this solar charge controller over here. This is going to give much more advanced features into the solar panel. So what this basically is doing is giving you the automatic battery charging feature along with the full load control capability. So it has got the built-in microcontroller here, and on this side you will connect the solar panel, on this side you will connect the battery, and on this side you will connect the load. So if the battery voltage is falls below the threshold, if the battery voltage is not sufficient, the load will be turned off and the solar panel will charge this battery. So this is taken care of by the solar charge controller. The solar charge controller will handle this case, and whenever it sees the battery voltage is below the threshold, it takes the voltage from the solar panel and it uses those voltages to charge the battery. And when the battery voltage is sufficient, it will drive the load. So this is the full load control capability. And you can also turn the load manually using this button over here. So we have got three control buttons here. This button here is used for the menu. This is the menu button here. This is the increment and decrement button. So you can increase the voltages using this button, decrease the voltage using this button. And this button can also be used to manually turn the load either on or off. So it has also got the two USB ports here, as you can see, which you can use to charge your phones or gadgets. So this is one of the interesting feature to have. And one more interesting thing that I need to tell you, there is it has got different battery options. You can use this types of battery for this solar charge controller. You can have different types of battery. And when the battery voltage falls below the threshold, then this arrow, as you can see here, starts to blink. That means that the solar panel is also charging the battery. So it has got numerous features, and you can take a look at each of the features on the link below. This is the user manual of this this controller over here, so you can take a look at them. As before, we have used the water pump, 12 volt water pump, which is going to be controlled via relay. We have got the 16x4 LCD as opposed to the previous one, which was using the 16x2 LCD. We have got the Arduino MEGA controller here as before, And this is the schematic, the circuit diagram, the schematic of the whole project. And so as you can see, these two motors are used for, one is used for forward movements, and this one is used for brush. And those two motors are using motor driver here. And the third motor, which was used for the horizontal movement, is going to use the relay module here. So this second relay will be used to control the water pump here. And the three ultrasonic sensors, as you can see here, this one is the current sensor, voltage sensor, the RTC module here, and the temperature and humidity measurements are done via this DHT-11 sensor. This one is the buck converter, which is going to take voltage from the load, which can be 12 to 24 volt, and it will convert these voltages to down to 5 volt, which will be used to power the controller and some of the peripherals that are connected to this controller over here. So let's see the working of the video.